What's up? It's your girl QTP from the Queen Palace. Hi. Let's talk about Gabrielle Union and Dwayne Wade son not being messy on my YouTube channel. We're just gonna talk facts, okay? We love everyone. All right, now this is a topic that I'm going to address very delicately, okay? We're not going to poke fun. Zaya has been going to LGBT parades and things of that nature, which is an indicator that he identifies within that community, which is fine if that's what he wants. And it's great that his parents are supportive. I saw a picture on Easter with Gabrielle Union and the rest of the Wade's family. And then I saw Zaya at the end of the line with her friend, a Caucasian boy or girl. I don't know what's going on, but it was a nice picture. I mean, I thought nothing of it. And then after Easter Monday, I get on Facebook and I see additional pictures that was taken. And now I see Zaya kissing that white boy that was at the end of that line. Kiss like this. And I'm looking. Zaya looked like a feminine boy. And the person who he kissing looked like a feminine boy. Or a girl that want to be a boy. That's fine too, because people do and like whatever they do and like. That's all right. But we're now in a space where we're more open to different things. We're saying, okay, if that's what they like, that's what they like. If that's what he like, that's what he like. Do you think it was appropriate for Zaya to be posted up kissing her boo and for the pictures to be shared with the public? But my stance is that Zaya is a child. I don't care how much you want to twist and flip it and toss it. Zaya is a child. Zaya do not and should not be making adult decisions. We kissing and posting it for the world to see. Your parents allowing you to be so. Are the parents allowing Zaya to go in the room upstairs one-on-one with the little boo? I mean, how open, how free are we? You allow them to kiss and be alone too? To touch up on each other? I mean, what's going on? Now, parents are a lot more lax these days. The kids do a lot more things than we used to do. Trust me. And some of y'all was doing these things. But if the parents did allow them to kiss and, you know, whatever, okay, I don't think it should have been posted. Everything do not need to be shared with the world. Now, as I've said before, I'll say it again. Kids are being exposed to a lot more things at a younger age than we were. Kids, if you watch the blogs and stuff in the news, kids are coming to school with drugs. Kids coming to school talking about sex. Kids coming to school fighting on sight at a young age. They're angry. They're traumatized. It's a lot going on. The world is more wicked now. I mean, it was wicked before, don't get me wrong, but it's just a lot more of just hypersexual things going on. I can see, and listen to me when I said this, listen to me. I can see kids evolving mentally so much, but they say, we have rights. We have rights. I do not feel like a child anymore. I want to be viewed as an adult at the age of 14, 13, 12. I can see kids saying, yeah, I'm 10. But I've had a cycle, or I'm going through puberty, so I deserve to be attracted to and sleep with and do whatever I want to with whoever I want to with. And I can see laws being changed. I'm telling you, I can see it. You might think it's nasty, but right now we're not there. But these kids are feeling things at a younger age. And not only are they feeling these things, they're ready to act. You think it's sick? People who are now being arrested for sleeping with minors, I can see a point in time where it will be allowed. The lines will be so blurred. Watch. And when I tell you something, you might think, oh, she's just crazy. I'm telling you this because I feel this. And I'm usually right. Kids are going, I see it bright as day. I see it. Kids are going to be allowed to sleep with adults. Why? Because kids are already seeing and experiencing adult things. The innocence that kids used to have, it's like the past now. Now, don't get me wrong. You still have some kids who were innocent. But if you look at the vast majority, it's not a whole lot anymore. Because of this phone that we have in our hands all day, and your child have phones in their hands all day, and you put no kind of parental measures to block them from seeing certain things, so they see everything. Yeah. They see things, they research things, their minds are curious, and they feel they know so much. I didn't know certain things until later in life. I have kids coming to me, talking to me about adult things. Or I hear them talking about adult things. I'm like, I didn't even know what that was when I was their age. And I remember I would ask adults things as a child. They're like, how you know about that? We're evolving. So just be on the lookout for that. But anyway, if my child was 14, 15, I understand. Well, first of all, no, I don't want you kissing nobody. But I understand you might do. But if you do do it, it should be on the low. I don't see it. We're not kissing. But Gabriel and Dwayne trying to be open, trying to be great parents. And it's good that I will say it is truly a beautiful thing to feel comfortable coming to your parents about how you feel on the inside. Because you like the same sex, you still deserve respect. You still deserve to be loved. You still deserve to be respected and able to fulfill all your dreams just like me. I just think kids need to be kids. What do you think?